Good morning, students. Today, I will start one new chapter from your geography book, chapter 9, that is soil resources. Soil are important as man depends on it for the food it provides him as well as the animals that live on earth. If the soil are fertile, production is more, and such areas support a high density of population. The parent material relief features, climate and natural vegetation are responsible for the formation of soil. Since India has a varied topography and climate, so it is natural that large variety of soil are found here. Now, how the soil is formed? As you all know, soil is formed due to the weathering of rocks. It is defined as the detachment and transportation of soil by agents of denudation such as weathering, running water and wind. In mountains where the slopes are steep, water is an important agent of erosion. Faulty agricultural practices, overgrazing and deforestation leads to soil erosion. Improved agricultural practices reduce pressure of grazing, and afforestation can help in the construction of soils. Now, I'll explain you about the soil fertility. Soil fertility refers to the strength of the soil to support plant life. Fertile soil has the following characteristics. First, it contains adequate amount of moisture to supply essential nutrients to the plants. It has sufficient depth to enable the plants to grow their roots as per their requirements. It is rich in nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium that are necessary for basic plant nourishment. It contains organic matter that improves the structure of soil. So these are the soil fertility. Now I'll explain you about the soil classification. Now, according to its location, soil can be categorized as residual or the sedimentary soil and transported soil. First, I will explain you about the residual or the sedimentary soil. Almost all soils are formed in situ, that is, they are formed in their original position by the breaking up of parent rocks. They include black soil, red soil, laterite soil, desert soil, etc. Now, transported soil. These soils are transported by various agents of erosion and consist of sediments carried and deposited by rivers and winds. India is a vast region with varied natural environment. We find several physiographic regions and different types of climate. Therefore, a number of soil types have developed here. Now, first I will explain about the alluvium soil. The different soils which are found in India, they are the alluvium soils, black soil, red soil, laterite soil, desert soil, forest and hill soils, saline and alkaline soils, and the mercy soils. So first, I will explain you about the alluvium soil. These soils are formed by the sediments brought down by rivers. They are also rich in chemical ingredients. The rivers deposit very fine particles of soil called alluvium in their plants during the course of their long journey. Alluvial soil is also known as the riverine soil because it is mainly found in the river basins. It is a mixture of sand, clay and silt called loam. These have been deposited by three important river systems, the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. These soils occupy 40% of the land area. The entire northern plains are made up of these soils. These soils are also predominant in coastal plains and deltas, particularly in the deltas of the Mahanadi, the Godavari and the Krishna and the Kaveri rivers. On the basis of its age, the alluvial soil is of two types, Bhangar and Khadar. The Bhangar or the old alluvium is composed of lime, nodules or the kankar and has a clay composition. The Khadar is light in color and is composed of neon deposits. Bhangar soil is an old alluvium soil known as the Bhangar, occupy the large part of northern plains, where the Khadar soil, it is in this is the area in the northern plains that lie below flood levels, is made up of the Khadar. Bhangar is not very fertile, but Khadar is very fertile and ideal for the intensive cultivation. Now the distribution. First is inland alluvium. These soils are found on the plains of the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra rivers, extending from Punjab and Sindh, which is then the Pakistan, to Bangladesh and Assam. Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal have alluvial soil. These soils also cover a part of the Gujarat and a few patches in the Rajasthan. Next is Deltic alluvium. The Deltic alluvium is found in the deltas of the Ganga, Brahmaputra, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri rivers. Coastal alluvium. It is of tidal origin. It is found in the coastal strips of peninsular India. It is also found in the plains of Gujarat. Now, let me explain you about the characteristics of the alluvium soil. It is formed by the deposition of the river load as it flows from its upper to the lower course. In the upper reaches of the river valleys, near the place of their origin, the soils are coarse. Soil particles are large and non-uniform. Such soils are predominant in Piedmont plains. Piedmont plains means plains near the foot of the mountains. As we move further down a river valley, the soil particles become smaller and more uniform. They are found up to a depth of 500 meters. The alluvial soil of the upper Ganga Valley is dry, porous, sandy, fent, yellow and consists of clay and organic matter, while the soils of the lower Ganga Valley, either of the West Bengal and Bangladesh, are more compact, less coarse and more moist. It is light and porous, therefore easily tillable. It is a fertile soil as it is rich in minerals, especially potash and lime. It is suitable for the growth of a large variety of rabi and the kharif crops. In next chapter, I will explain you what are rabi and the kharif crops. Soil is in the dry areas are more alkaline. Now the crops which are common to grow in this soil, they are the soils are fertile and suitable for cultivation of rice, wheat, sugarcane, cotton, tobacco, gram and oil seeds. In the lower Ganga Brahmaputra Valley, they are useful for jute cultivation. And as we know, jute cultivation, where the jute is cultivated in the Ganga Brahmaputra Delta, that is called the Sundarban Delta. That area, it is rich in alluvium soil. Up to this, I hope it is clear to all of you. थैंक यू, गॉड ब्लेस यू ऑल।